kept from the press. But tonight, our Leonard Maltin has an exclusive peek behind the scenes of the next adventure for our second ET First.
May the force be with you, bro.
Much rain as we can get, much wind as we can get.
Drop cameras.
The footage, which will premiere on the official Star Wars website tomorrow, centers on a fight between Ewan McGregor's Obi-Wan Kenobi and Jango Fett, played by Temuera Morrison.
George, what's my lines today, George? Any dialogue?
You draw your guns and you pow, pow, pow.
The fight scene with Obi-Wan Kenobi. The space chase through asteroid planets.
The thing fogs up, I can't see anything. Oh, well, I'll just carry on like this. I can just see this blur coming down.
Jango has a young son, Boba Fett, who figured as a bounty hunter in The Empire Strikes Back. In this film, which takes place before Empire, he's played by 14-year-old Daniel Logan.
Can you do that? Fly through asteroids? Fight? Shoot?
May the force be with me.
It wouldn't rain up in space.
Understandably, there's a lot of pressure for this movie to be a hit when it lands in theaters on May 16th. Remember, the last episode came close to earning an astounding $1 billion.
Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones, are in the new Vanity Fair on stands February 12th. Natalie Portman and Hayden Christensen get close while Ewan McGregor does a stunt and R2-D2 gets unpacked. Episode 2 lands in theaters May 16th.
Glimpse behind the scenes for another ET First. In this clip, Jedi in training Anakin Skywalker, played by Hayden Christensen, zooms through a massive futuristic city as he rescues his master, Obi-Wan Kenobi, played by Ewan McGregor.
What took us so long?
Oh, you know, Master. I couldn't find a speeder that I really liked. There he is, with the open cockpit and the right speed capabilities.
You spent as much time practicing your saber techniques as you do your witch. You would rival Master Yoda as a swordsman.
I thought I already did.
Only in your mind, my very young apprentice.
Underlying melodic tone of this should be much more of the ominous strings we were using earlier.
Director George Lucas picked five-time Academy Award winner John Williams to compose the score for the film's huge sequences, as he has for each of the Star Wars movies. The soundtrack, with four different collectible CD covers, hits stores next Tuesday and is highlighted by the dramatic new love theme, Across the Stars.
You know, this is the first time we've really done a full-out love story, so I wanted to have the love theme be something very, very emotional and very poetic.
So I think the task and opportunity for the musician might have been to provide the erotic aspects that couldn't be shown. I think George had those things on his mind when he described to me the need for a love theme that was like the great love stories of the films of earlier times.
Doesn't fly into theaters until May 16th, but there will be special charity screenings on May 12th.
Well, Natalie, as you recall, was an icy young queen in the last Star Wars movie, The Phantom Menace. But in the next episode, she's found love with Hayden Christensen. And our Leonard Maltin reports on the sexy new scene.
Forbidden love was never sweeter than in Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones, opening May 16th.
We could keep it a secret.
We'd be living a lie. I couldn't do that.
Natalie returns, all grown up, as sexy Padme Amidala.
I think the biggest difference is showing a bit more skin in this one. This is my sexed up version, I guess, of the queen. I got over the hump of 18, so I'm allowed to show tummy now, I guess.
Padme falls hard for bad boy Anakin Skywalker, as played by Hayden.
She sees the sort of darkness to him, but obviously that's always intriguing. It's always like the bad boys.
She's very beautiful and intelligent, and it would be easy for anyone, I think, to fall in love with her.
Padme is attracted to Anakin, mainly for his looks. I mean, let's be honest.
Thanks a lot. I got the answer from Hayden Christensen himself.
She's a beautiful girl, and it wasn't that hard. Everything about it was kind of, you know, very enjoyable.
You're exactly the way I remember you in my dreams.
Already, publicity surrounding the film is intense. Entertainment Weekly has two special covers hitting newsstands tomorrow with new images from the film inside. And for a relatively new face like Hayden, the frenzy is an adjustment.
When I was back in Toronto, trying to go in and get a pack of Doritos, and my face was on it, and my friends were waiting for me in the car, and there was just no way I could walk back with, you know, a bag of chips that had my face on it.
The film doesn't open until next Thursday, but the cast is already gearing up for episode 3. Filming will take place in Australia next summer, and Hayden gave a hint of what's to come.
Well, Ewan and I have made a little bit of a pact to go out there a couple of months before and just get really good with our lightsabers, because there has to be a huge falling out between Obi-Wan and I when it leads to a big fight.
Thanks a lot, Leonard, and good news for all you Star Wars fans. Start lining up now, because only 2 more years until episode 3 comes out. From Moscow to Miami, the door is finally opened, and after weeks of waiting in line, the Star Wars faithful finally got to see episode 2. But can Anakin Skywalker and Padme Amidala defeat the powerful Spider-Man?
Been in line for 350 some odd hours.
378 hours.
The legions of fans poured in to see Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones, last night. The movie played throughout the night, starting at midnight. Star Wars raises its lightsabers against the phenomenally successful Spider-Man. We have the special effect secrets behind the web-slinging.
On MTV. As the battle rages at the box office, the cast of the latest blockbuster On the Block talks to us about the cutthroat competition. From Natalie to Hayden, London to LA, the Star Wars stars covered the globe for their premieres.
Everybody's going to say, Spider-Man set a standard. That's great. That's one weekend. This movie will be enduring like it always has. Star Wars is always Star Wars.
In London, Halle Berry made a surprise appearance with husband Eric Benet. And in New York, Natalie came to the premiere benefiting the Children's Aid Society. But while she made the fashion grade in her Zac Posen gown, this college student was missing her finals.
I'm actually going back to take the rest of my finals right after this.
Her action figure failed the Natalie test.
Look at my boobs. Clearly not true to life.
At the Hollywood premiere, benefiting the Fulfillment Fund, Ewan McGregor showed us his new toy, and Dawson's Creek's Kerr Smith showed up with his fiancée, Harmony. Nice ring. In his hometown of Toronto, Anakin Skywalker Hayden brought his mom to the premiere that benefited Child Find Ontario. And in San Francisco, George Lucas brought Princess Leia, Carrie Fisher, to the California Mentor Foundation benefit premiere before he had to get back to work on Star Wars Episode 3.
I've been working on it for about a month now.
With the clones, Star Wars Episode 2 won the race for the weekend box office supremacy and knocked off the mighty Spider-Man. Will soar to number one with an estimated $86 million. The Spider-Man unwound and fell to second with $46 million. Anakin and Padme helped give Star Wars the third best movie opening in history. Only Spider-Man and Harry Potter were better.